like a rod against my spine. It keeps me straight down the line and deep in.
Hey everybody, how are y'all doing today? Today I'm going to make chicken Alfredo. I am super excited for this recipe that I found about through, I can't remember the name, but it's somebody I just recently subscribed to. He's got a lot of awesome recipes. I will be putting his name somewhere around here and you'll see it. I got this recipe idea from him, but it is not exactly how he did it, so if that makes sense. And the reason being is I'm not using tofu noodles. I'm going to use cauliflower, and I'm not using olive oil. I am using coconut oil, and I am not using mushrooms. I am using peppers. So that's the only difference. And the reason being is just because that's what I had in my kitchen, and I didn't feel like going to the grocery store. But I really wanted to try this Alfredo sauce that he made. So the Alfredo sauce will be exactly how he made it, except for those factors. So right now I've got the coconut oil heating up in the pan, and I'm about to throw in my chicken. So let's get to it, guys.
Like I mentioned, once the pan starts steaming, that's when you can add your chicken. He used chicken thighs. I'm going to use chicken breast. Once you get all your chicken on there, you're going to want to add in some butter just to kind of make that chicken a little more tender, and plus butter's good. So put my butter in real quick so I can fry up with some butter. And then I'm going to add my seasonings. Now, for my seasonings, I am going to be adding some garlic and herb Mrs. Dash. Love this stuff. I just love Mrs. Dash, to be honest. She is like the bomb. Never met the woman, but I think she's good people. So you want all that pretty seasoned. Now he used minced garlic, which is great, and I think there is some minced garlic up in this Mrs. Dash, but I'm not going to use any because I don't have any. I'm also going to use some Mrs. Dash original blend just to give it that kind of lemony. I'm only going to use a tidbit of that. So there we go. And I'm also going to use some garlic salt. Any garlic salt is fine. You just want to pay attention to the ingredients and make sure that there is no like cornstarch or anything like that in the ingredients. And this one there is not. So just going to add some garlic salt to that because I like my stuff super garlicky. I love the taste of garlic. So you're going to let this cook all the way through. Issues because I couldn't find my little honey whiny pinchers. That's what I call these things. I'm going to go ahead and just flip it once right now. That way I can get the seasoning on the other side as well. That's just how I like to do it. You don't have to. You can cook it that way all you want. I just like my chicken super seasoned because that's how I like it. So I give it a good flip if it will cooperate with me. Oh, I'm sorry, y'all couldn't even see me flipping that whole time. So I give it a good flip. You do not have to do this. This is just what I do for seasoning purposes. I like mine to be super seasoned, super good. So I flip it, and then I just add a tiny bit more seasoning on the other side. You don't want to overdo the seasoning, but I love a lot of seasoning. So that's just preference-wise. So now I'm going to come back at it with just the Mrs. Dash garlic and herb only, and I'm just going to add a little spritz of that on the other side as well. Just because I kind of like my chicken like almost coated with seasoning, because I'm weirdo. But I don't add much, you know what I mean? I just add enough to get the job done, and then all of that juice that's in the bottom is going to be perfectly seasoned and ready to go for your Alfredo sauce. Let's add a little more butter. Just because. I think I'm going to put some in the middle there. Some over here. Just get more juiciness. So after this is all done, we're going to come back and start adding in the sauce. And I will show you how that is done in uno momento, por favor.
I'm going to do my sauce in the same skillet as my chicken, but I changed my mind on that because with those seasonings that I did add, the sauce wouldn't come out right. So it would just taste burnt, I think, because if you watch my channel, you know I like to overcook my meat. It's just a personal thing I have to do. Okay, so here's what I'm doing. So in this pan is the pan I'm going to be making the sauce, and I've got some butter sizzling up in there. This pan is where I'm going to be steaming my cauliflower. So I have probably about, I would say about half a cup to a cup of water with lots of butter, okay? And I'm going to chop some cauliflower up and put it in here and put the lid on it and steam it. And over here, I'll show you in just a second.
Okay, so I decided to add in some broccoli because I forgot I had broccoli. By myself! Anyway, so I decided to put some broccoli on to steam as well. And in this, I'm going to add some pink Himalayan salt and maybe a touch of some garlic salt. And then I'm going to put the lid on and let that steam.
So over here in my chicken, I've got my peppers all chopped up in there. And it's just kind of on a low heat, just hanging out, waiting to have Alfredo sauce poured all over it. Boiling butter. So what you're going to do, this is on a medium-low heat. Gosh, yogurt. You're going to put some heavy whip up in here. This is going to be your Alfredo sauce. So yeah, you mix some heavy whip and some butter together. Now in his video, it showed that he did this with his chicken, like all together. I'm doing it this way simply because, like I said, I don't want those seasonings to be too much. So in this, I'm going to add a tidbit of pepper, just like a teensy tiny bit. Some pepper, that looks like a lot, but it's not, I promise. So I'm going to add some pepper in there. Stir it up. And then I'm going to add some garlic salt. Like I said, I like my stuff super garlicky, but just a teeny bit of garlic salt should do since we have so much on the rest. I think that just a little bit will be fine for this. Okay. And a tiny bit of salt. Once it starts kind of boiling, you're going to want to add your Parmesan, shredded Parmesan cheese up to the mix. Mm.
I'm gonna put quite a bit of that. It's kind of the X factor for this whole Alfredo. And sorry guys, sorry. Okay, so you got that in there, and now you just kind of stir it all up. And there it is. Creamy chicken Alfredo sauce. So you just want to put this right on top of your chicken. And voila! I'm going to show y'all the finished product in just a second. Look how creamy it is, though. Look at that. Ooh, I'm excited.
I'm so excited, and I just can't hide it. I'm about to lose control, and I think I like it.
And here it is, guys. Chicken Alfredo. Over a bed of cauliflower and broccoli. Look at that butter and oil down in there. You just know it's gonna be good. So I made some green beans to go with it because I love my green beans. So let's taste this stuff.
So I kind of cheated and I tasted the Alfredo sauce before I did my taste test for y'all. But just the sauce, and the sauce came out fantastic. My daughter got it too, and she's eating it with her chips like nachos. So here it is. Oh my gosh. Thank you so much for this recipe. Oh my gosh. That is like heaven in my mouth. That is so good. Oh my goodness. This might gonna be a regular at my household, and I am so happy that I have so much leftovers. It's fantastic. I give this like a 20 out of 10, y'all. This is probably the best recipe I have made thus far on keto eating. It doesn't even taste like a keto meal. I mean, I'm not saying keto meals taste bad, like, but it tastes the closest to like southern cooking hearty comfort food that I've had since I've been eating keto. Oh, it tastes so good. I can't wait to take another bite, so I'm gonna let you guys go try this recipe. It is good. Okay, so if you want to see more of this beautiful face and you want to see some videos like this, hit that subscribe button. And if you're already subscribed, hit the little bell next to it. You will get a notification every single time I post a new video. How awesome is that? Bye, guys.